In this video, I will show you how to make a simple four-legged walking robot using 3D printed parts. The design consists of only 5 main parts, including the top and bottom plates, arm connectors, legs, and servo holders. The 4 legs of the robot consist of 4 arm parts and 4 leg parts. A total of 8 hobby servo motors are used for the robot movement, 4 in the arms and 4 in the legs. On the circuit side, an ESP32 board was preferred, but the project can be easily controlled with Arduino boards. The Bluetooth feature of the ESP board was preferred for wireless communication, and a simple application was created for control. The app allows you to control the robot's movements such as walking, turning, and jumping with simple commands. This project is easy to assemble and use, making it a great choice for students, teachers, or anyone interested in robotics. Let's get started. First of all, before assembling the servo motors, the arm servos to be placed on the base must be adjusted to the 90-degree starting position. I have shared a basic code for the initial positions. As you can see, I have fixed 3 servo motors. Let's mount the 4th and last servo motor together. The holders on the servo base may remain slack according to the type of servo motor. In this case, you can keep it fixed with the help of some hot glue. In this section, fix the arm and leg connectors, which consist of 2 separate parts, together with a bolt and nut. Attach the fixed connector to the base servo. Then, with the connector at a diagonal angle, place the servo horn and fix it to the servo motor by tightening the screw. Finally, fix the end of the servo horn to the connector using a screw. It is not necessary to do this, but fixing it prevents looseness. Now that the arm is complete, let's move on to leg assembly. Before fixing the servo motors to be used in the leg, you need to bring them to a starting angle of 60 degrees. Then place the holder and leg part, fix the leg part to the servo motor with the appropriate screw. Insert the leg into the connector and attach the servo horn so that the leg is in the right angle position. Then fix the servo horn with the screws. Now prepare the other 3 legs and complete the assembly. Now that the assembly of the arms and legs is complete, we can move on to the power part of the circuit. A 7.4-volt battery will be enough for the circuit. The base part was designed for the size of a 3S LiPo battery, but the battery in my workshop was damaged, and I had to use an 11.1-volt battery. If you are going to use a 7.4-volt battery, you can skip this part. I placed the battery under the base and fixed it with a cable tie. Due to the battery change, I included a voltage step-down module in the power circuit. I set the voltage output to 7 volts with the help of the adjustment screw on the module and connected the battery inputs. After placing the module on the base, let's continue by assembling the upper base where the circuit board will be fixed. All the parts of the robot are assembled. Let's move on to the circuit board. I designed a circuit board that controls 16 servo motors and can be attached to an ESP32 board. As always, I chose PCBWay for high-quality circuit board prints. Also, PCBWay offering great gifts and incredible discounts for the new year. Last 7 days for new year deals. Visit the link in the description to check both this project details and new year discounts. You can also find the list of required components in the video descriptions. Easy solderable components are preferred. Basic soldering knowledge will be enough. Now it's time for soldering. Now that the board is ready, let's place it on the robot and then make the servo motor connections. The source code section shows which pins the servo motors are connected to. The robot is almost ready. Remove the ESB board and connect it to your computer, then open the shared source code. First, let's install ESP32. From the file, go to Preferences and add the shared ESP32 board manager URL. This step ensures that we can install the necessary ESP32 tools. Now, go to Board Manager, search for ESP32, and click Install. This adds the ESP32 board support to the Arduino editor. Now we can take a closer look at the code. The code contains two libraries. Bluetooth Serial is used to handle Bluetooth communication. ESP32 Servo is a library specifically designed to control servo motors with ESP32 boards. The application sends designated numbers via Bluetooth to activate generated commands such as up, down, walk, and others. These numbers are defined in the app, and the commands are interpreted in the code to trigger different robot movements. In this section, we specify the GPIO pins to which the servo motors are connected. Each arm and leg of the robot is controlled by separate servo motors. The robot's movements are defined with specific limits for the arms and legs. The speed of these movements is controlled by the speed variable. In the loop section, the code checks if any data is received from the Bluetooth app. If data is available, it is read and stored in the data variable. Based on this data, specific robot functions are triggered. When a command is received, the robot performs actions like walk, rotate, or reset to a stable position. That's the working principle and requirements of the code. Now upload the code to the board, and then let's move to the application side. We will be using MIT App Inventor, a free and drag-and-drop tool for developing Android apps. After logging into App Inventor by email, upload the shared AIA file of the app I created. This way, you can examine the blocks and build your own Android installation file without any trust issues. Then all you need to do is install the app on your phone or tablet. Now let's talk a little bit about the interface of the app. There is a button to list Bluetooth devices. Just below it, I added a text label showing the connection status. Finally, I added 6 buttons to trigger the robot's motion functions. In the block section, there are a few conditions that initiate Bluetooth communication at the very beginning. Then the data type and data functions to be sent for each movement button were created. It's that simple. Now we have an application. Now it's time to control the robot. You can find all the details of the project from the link in the video description. Thank you for watching.